This presentation is on factors affecting global warming. Notice we're calling it global warming instead of climate change. This is presented by Mark Shore for Data 620 at UMGC for Professor Minta, November of 2019. For any person that still doesn't believe that global warming is happening, my first two graphs show that climate is warming in the summer and winter. This particular figure shows that there is an increase in the average July temperature of 2.8 degrees plus or minus 0.07 degrees. I'll show you this. This is the trend line for the data points going from 1962 up through 2019. Here are the data points. Here is the trend line. We went with linear because you can kind of see a linear trend going up here. The differences from year to year tend to be constant. And we have our 95% confidence interval for all trend lines. In other words, 95% of the trend lines for the data for the entire population will be between these this upper and lower bound. And then we have our forecasted line right here. And notice that the forecast line shows more is closer to the line in terms of later years. And that's because the forecasted line uses exponential smoothing. And what that does is it uses the later points to judge what the forecasted line should be. So you can see how this is off down here, but we're not concerned with that. We're concerned with the forecast. So like if we go out to 2030, you can see that in 2030, the forecasted departure from average, that's what the zero represents, the average temperature, is actually clear up to 2.837 degrees Fahrenheit higher than the average for the baseline, which was 1901 to 1999. And this is just for the summer months. And that has a precision of plus or minus 0.73 of a degree. So I totally believe in this. I hope other people do too. But this is the way that we have warming in the summer. Now, some people think, well, that's only going on in the summer, and they call it climate change because they think that in the winter months, it's getting colder. No, it's not. It's getting warmer. And you have the same trend. You see out here in 2030, we got a departure from the average. Right here is the average. If you would look at the average from 1900 to 1950, that average would be actually another like half degree or a whole degree lower for the first half of the century compared to the second half. So if we looked at that departure, it would be even greater. Up here, winter months, about the same, 2.77 degrees hotter by 2030, and that's Fahrenheit. And I even broke this up into the hemispheres, north and south hemisphere, but it didn't have the number of graphs to show it. Same trend whether you look at north or southern hemisphere for winter or summer. Figure 3 shows an increase in the CO2 levels over the same period of time. The blue graph is showing the CO2 levels, the actuals with the predicted quadratic model right on it. And the reason I use the quadratic models is not only because we can see that there's a curve going up here, but the difference of the differences tend to be constant. And that's a good indication to use a quadratic model. We forecast the later bits out here, and you can see that the CO2 in 2030 is supposed to be at 442.3 plus or minus 13. Prior to this, for the last 100,000 years or so or more before this, CO2 levels always ran between 273 and 280 or so. And this is world population. We have the actuals predicted, the trend lines, the confidence intervals for the trend line, and also the predicted values for world population. And we're getting up close to 8.6 billion people by 2030. Figure 4 here shows the paralleled trend lines for both CO2, which is in blue, and also global difference from the departure from normal average temperature, which is shown on this dual axis here on the right-hand side. You can see as CO2 increases, basically the temperature difference from average is increasing in pretty parallel rate. And I think that's a good indication that CO2 is a main reason for global warming. Checking with multiple sources, the main two reasons for global warming which are causing the CO2 levels to increase is coal emissions from power plants and also cars on the road. The main one is coal power plants. And the main place that's using coal for burning to make electricity is China. And we can see from 2000 to 2018, the growth in megawatts, thousands of megawatts produced from coal. Now, that is a main factor. They're putting more carbon dioxide and carbon into the atmosphere than any other country. And finally, we have our references right here. I have several other references that talk about many things, but these are the ones I included in the presentation.